大家好，我是郭文婷，欢迎收看当代中文。
大家好， I'm Curtis Evans and welcome to Contemporary Chinese. Now, Wen Ting, I have a little favor to ask you.
Go ahead.
A friend of mine is going to be living in China and he wants to know how to rent a house. Well, I told him you might be able to teach him.
That's pretty easy. You can ask him to tune in right now because what we are going to learn is about renting houses.
Tune in right now. Okay, well, I'll give him a call.
What?
Uh, 听说您的房子要出
租。是的。如果你们想租的话，现在就可以搬进去。
在几楼？
六楼。上去看看吧。
有没有电梯？
没有，得走上去。
每天走上走下太累了。
没关系，还可以锻炼身体呢。请进吧。请进吧。
这套房子一个月多少钱？
3000块。
太贵了。
一点儿也不贵。你看，这套房子有两个大房间，电视机、电冰箱、洗衣机、电话都有，还有空调。
要付押金吗？
付1000块押金。搬出去的时候还给你。这是合同。
我们回去想想吧，明天打电话告诉你。这合同我们可以带回去看看吗？
当然可以。明天我等你们的电话。
Well, there are quite a few words to learn in this vocabulary. Let's say them together.
房子，房子。出租，出租。房东，房东。租，租。搬，搬。楼，楼。电梯，电梯。累，累。锻炼，锻炼。电视机，电视机。一台电视机。电冰箱，电冰箱。一台电冰箱。洗衣机，洗衣机。一台洗衣机。空调，空调。一台空调。付，付。押金，押金。合同，合同。贷，贷。
听说您的房子要出租。
是的，如果你们想租的话，现在就可以搬进去。
在几楼？
六楼。上去看看吧。
有没有电梯？
没有，得走上去。
每天走上走下太累了。
没关系，还可以锻炼身体呢。请进吧。请进吧。
这套房子一个月多少钱？
3000块。
太贵了。
一点儿也不贵。你看，这套房子有2个大房间，电视机、电冰箱、洗衣机、电话都有，还有空调。
要付押金吗？
付1000块押金。搬出去的时候还给你。这是合同。
我们回去想想吧，明天打电话告诉你。这合同我们可以带回去看看吗？
当然可以。明天我等你们的电话。
每天走上走下太累了。
The language point we are going to learn today is verb plus directional complement. The directional verb immediately following the verb and indicating the direction of the action is called the directional complement. There are 2 kinds of directional complement, the simple one and the compound one. Here are some examples of the simple complement of direction.
他从商店买来一台空调。
He bought an air conditioner in the store.
他从商店买来一台空调。他从包里拿出一本书。
He took a book out of the bag.
他从包里拿出一本书。
你上去坐会儿吧。
不上去了，我得马上回房间去，有人找我。
他从中国回来，给我带来了很多茶叶。
So what we've just learned must be very useful for my friend who's going to live in China.
Yes, actually, in addition to the sheer joy of learning Chinese, we must learn it for some practical purposes as well.
And you know, some of the daily problems that crop up, well, those are the ones that I don't really feel confident in how to handle. Do you have any suggestions?
Don't worry, actually. The next situational dialogue is like that. The air conditioner is broken on a hot summer day. So what do you say in negotiating with the landlord?
This will be interesting.
Hmm? 这么热的天，房间里没有空调，真让人生气。
是啊，太不像话了。给钱太太打个电话，看她怎么回答。是钱太太吗？
是我，什么事儿？
空调已经拆下来好几天了，修好了没有啊？
对不起，还没修好。师傅说这台空调太旧了，没办法修。
那怎么办啊？
看来只好换台新的。
那就麻烦您快点买来装上去。
我一有空就去买。
您什么时候有空呢？我们热死了。
这个真不好意思。这样吧，我今天下午就去电器商店看一下，如果能买到的话，马上就让商店送过来。
生气，生气。拆，拆。师傅，师傅。旧，旧。办法，办法。只好，只好。装，装。电器，电器。送，送。
这么热的天，房间里没有空调，真让人生气。
是啊，太不像话了。给钱太太打个电话，看她怎么回答。是钱太太吗？
是我，什么事儿？
空调已经拆下来好几天了，修好了没有啊？
对不起，还没修好。师傅说这台空调太旧了，没办法修。
那怎么办啊？
看来只好换台新的。
那就麻烦您快点买来装上去。
我一有空就去买。
您什么时候有空呢？我们热死了。
这个真不好意思。这样吧，我今天下午就去电器商店看一下，如果能买到的话，马上就让商店送过来。现在就可以搬进去。
那就麻烦您快点买来装上去。
这合同我们可以带回去看看吗？
The other kind is called the compound complement of direction. For example,
现在就可以搬进去。
You can move in now.
现在就可以搬进去。这合同我们可以带回去吗？
Can we bring the contract back home?
这合同我们可以带回去吗？
If the verb has an object of a place, the object must follow 进、出、上 or 下 but must precede 来 or 去 for example,
他走进房间。
He walked into the room.
他走进房间。他走进房间来了。
He came into the room.
他走进房间来了。我们得走上楼去。
We must walk upstairs.
我们得走上楼去。
If the object is a thing instead of a place, it may have three possible positions.
他带了一份合同回来。
He brought back a contract.
他带了一份合同回来。他带回一份合同来。
He brought back a contract.
他带回一份合同来。他带回来一份合同。
He brought back a contract.
他带回来一份合同。
看，那有一辆车开过来了。
这幅画挂上去以后，房间就漂亮了。
请你站起来回答老师的问题。
他走上楼去了。
You know, Curtis, Housing has long been one of the biggest problems for Chinese. But now, more and more of them can afford to buy much larger houses. And sometimes, they even have spare houses to rent out. Years ago, things are totally different.
That's right, things certainly have improved.
Because of China's large population, housing in the cities were inadequate for a long time. Previously, a welfare housing allocation system, 福利分房制度, was in use, whereby organizations would provide their employees with housing in return for only a minimal amount of rent. Things are different now. Employee income has been increased greatly. So, the welfare housing allocation system has been abandoned. Now, employees usually have to purchase their own residences with a subsidy from their work unit. Since the beginning of economic reforms, many commercial high-rise apartment buildings have been built, so the housing situation has improved considerably.
Well, there certainly have been a lot of changes in the last 20 years since China has opened up to the outside world.
There certainly has. Looks like time is up today.
再见。
再见。